The PoE switch not only can provide data exchange, but also supply the PoE power for edge device, such like the IP camera, access point, VoIP phone. In this video, I'm going to talk about how do PoE switch work. I will start from three topics. The first topic is what this PoE switch will go through before it sends the power over the K5 or K6 Ethernet cable. The second topic is what is the actual power budget you can get from a single PoE port. The third session is how to pick a PoE switch. If you want to learn more about the PoE technology, please click the subscribe button below and hit the little bell, then you will get the notified whenever I release the new video. Before we dive into how do PoE switch work, let's run a quick test. This is the 8-port PoE switch. I have powered up this switch. Here is we have the short punch code. Let me use this short punch code to link one of the PoE port and connect to this IP camera. This IP camera support PoE. As we expected, now the camera is getting the power from the PoE switch. Then we'll see the data indicator is on, which means we are using single K5 Ethernet cable to provide data exchange, also the PoE power for this camera. Here we have the router. This router doesn't support PoE. What if we connect this cable to this router? Let's try. Just connect one of the RJ45 network port. As you can see, that nothing happened with the router because the router is not getting the PoE power from this PoE switch. The PoE switch doesn't release the power for this router. Before the switch sends the power to any IP device, there's four steps you need to go through. The first step is the verification. You need to verify the edge device is also support PoE. If the edge device doesn't support PoE like this router, it will not supply any power, but it will provide data exchange. The second step is the classification. It relates to the power budget. Then the switch will determine what is the maximum power budget you need to send through the single Ethernet cable. After verify and classify, then the PoE switch will start sending the power to this K5 or K6 Ethernet cable. That's the third step. The last step is the monitoring. If there are any abnormal, such like the overloading from your edge device, the PoE switch will shut down the power immediately. Then it will start verification again and classify, then powering and monitoring, just like a circle. There are three different verification from standard PoE, IEEE 802.3, AF, AT, and BT. This PoE specification determines what is the maximum power budget you can get from a single PoE port. For example, this is the PoE switch which supports AT, aka PoE Plus. You can get maximum 30 watts from a single PoE port. And the IEEE 802.BT is supply maximum up to 90 watts from a single PoE port. It increases 3 times power budget from the previous PoE standard. The reason is because the new PoE standard is taking all 4 twist pairs to send the power, but the PoE Plus only take half of the twist pair to send the power. That's one of the reasons why the new PoE standard IEEE 802.3 BT can supply up to 90 watt high power over single Ethernet port. Then, for example, this is the AT PoE switch. Can we get 30 watt for all the PoE port? Negative. This PoE switch is using the sharing power supply unit. The total power budget this PoE switch can supply is 120 watt. We got totally 8 port. If each port output 30 watt, then we need to have 240 watt. But the PoE switch only have equipped with the 120 watt PoE supply unit. So that means we cannot have 30 watt from each of the PoE port. But in the practical application, in most of the cases, we don't need to have such high power for each of the PoE port. That's the reason why when we decide the PoE switch, we may not have the full power for each of the PoE port. This is about the sharing the power. Actually, all the PoE switch using the sharing power supply unit. The last thing is about the actual power budget. This PoE switch, it can supply up to 30 watt from single PoE port. Can this PoE camera also get 30 watt? Also note, the reason is there's power loss in the transmission. According to the PoE design, the maximum power budget this edge device can get from PoE Plus is 25 watts. It's just about 25 watts. After consider the power loss, so even we use the short punch code to link the PoE switch to this PoE camera, if this camera needs 30 watts, it will not work because the PoE system, according to the specification, it already to be set to the 25 watts. The first thing you need to determine is how many ports you want to get from the PoE switch. There's a 4-port, 8-port, 16-port, 24-port, 48-port PoE switch. Remember we mentioned the PoE switch not only can work with the PoE device such as the IP camera, but also the non-PoE equipment, router, PC computer. So you can put all the network devices together and get the amount of the port you need. And it's always better to reserve a little bit margin, extra port for future use. The second thing to determine is the power budget. If you are working with the low voltage device such like the IP camera, PoE access point, the PoE Plus switch will be enough. You can supply up to 30 watts from a single Ethernet port. However, if you have some high power edge device such like the Pentium camera with a heater, you may need to use the PoE Plus Plus switch which can output 90 watts from a single Ethernet port. Also, you have to consider the total power budget, because the PoE switch is using the sharing power supply unit. It's just what is the total power amount you need to get from the whole switch. It's quite easier. You just put all the power budget from a single device, then put everything together, then you get the amount, you will know whether the power budget the PoE switch supply is enough or not. There are some other features such like the SFP slot. This switch comes with the SFP slot. You can use the fiber optic cable to connect this switch to another switch or just the access point at edge device. And there's manager and unmanager switch. The unmanager switch is simply plug and play. There's no need for configuration. You plug the device, plus the device to the switch. Then you got the data and power. You can configure the security policy for a network. Set up the VLAN, device network into different session. The standard PoE is limited to about 328 feet. If you have a long run network, I will recommend that you watch another video how to set up the PoE network up to 1600 feet.